Hey, so a couple of you guys requested a video showing off more of how I made my Instax back for my Hasselblad slash Kiev. Here we go. So this is basically my second prototype, and right now it's on a Kiev. A lot of tape at the moment, but you know, maybe someday I will make a 3D printed back or something. But you know, one step at a time. So if I'm gonna go through the process here, so I cut the faceplate with a Dremel and gave it enough space so the back of the Hasselblad could fit into it. I really needed to worry about the gears because all those gears are what spits out the actual instant photo. So I was originally gonna try to do it with a hand crank, but then I realized I could actually drive it with the motor that spits out the picture normally, which was good. So basically with mine, I wired it so you hold down the button and then the motor just runs, which runs the rollers and just spits out the picture. So one thing that my first prototype fell short in was that the black piece that holds in the actual instant film was too thick and it didn't push right up against where the curtain is and basically where the 120 film would be. So if I focused through the viewfinder, it wasn't, the pictures wouldn't come out in focus, obviously, because they're not where the film should be. So with this one, I really took that Dremel and I shaved off a lot of that black material. And then I actually took apart a film back from a different Kiev and I glued it into that area so it would fit the back of the camera perfectly. I thought that was a really, really smart idea. And one thing that I really, really like about this setup is the fact that the Kiev or the Hasselblad have a PC sync cord. So I can plug in to my strobes and basically shoot that onto the Instax film, which is pretty cool. So anyway, here's me on a shoot. This model's name was Megan, and I plugged into my strobes and I was able to take a few pictures. So things I definitely need to figure out with this setup is the fact that the film doesn't actually take up the whole area of where the film would take up on the medium format itself. So if you look through the viewfinder, you're seeing more than what the cropping is going to be on the photo. So I'm thinking about just making some lines on the ground glass to frame up what you're actually going to see. So might as well take a shot right now and show you how it works. Super original. I'm going to take a picture of my camera setup. Oh my god, this is super original. I also was worried a lot about light leaks, so I used gaffer tape like all over this sucker. Hopefully that won't be a super problem. So, I usually just shoot them and flip them over and let them develop, so maybe we'll just go in fast motion for a second here, or just cut, whatever. All right, there we go. A little bit out of focus, but you know, pretty cool. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna keep this project going and I will keep you guys posted on how it goes, but I think this was a fairly successful prototype, basically. Really getting that light tight seal is pretty tough. So I actually got some light proofing, I don't even know what to call it, material. So the next step for me is gonna be probably trying to legit light proof this setup. So that's the next thing for me.